V-belt and synchronous belt drives are widely used to change speeds and transmit torque from a driver, such as an electric motor, to the driven equipment. This video demonstrates the force deflection tensioning method for a V-belt drive. The same practices apply to synchronous belt drives. Use all required personal protective equipment. Disable equipment using proper lockout/tagout procedures. After installation and alignment of the shivs, it is time to tension the belt or belts. For guidance on the installation and alignment of shivs or synchronous sprockets, please refer to Dodge's belt drive installation and alignment videos. Proper belt tension is critical to successful operation. Insufficient tension causes slippage, resulting in premature wear on belts and shivs or sprockets. Over-tensioning can result in damage to the shaft or bearings in the connected equipment. To check tension, we will use a spring-loaded tension meter. This tool measures the magnitude of an applied force and the distance of deflection. It is highly recommended to use Dodge PT Wizard, Dodge's easy-to-use online selection program, to configure and receive the exact tensioning requirements for your belt drive. First, determine the span length. The span length is the unsupported length of the belt between the driver and driven shivs. The span length is easily found in the tensioning section of the passport selection. If the results from passport are unavailable, measure the span length manually. The spring-loaded tension meter uses two O-rings, one large and one small. The large O-ring is used to set the deflection distance, which is easily found in the passport selection. If the results from passport are not available, placement of the large O-ring is determined by dividing your span length by 64. In this example, the span length is 26 1/8 inches. Dividing by 64 results in large O-ring placement of approximately 0.4 inches. Set the small O-ring to 0. Seat the belts within the shiv grooves. For single belts, place a straight edge on the outside of each shiv. Next, at the center of the belt span, depress the tension meter until the large O-ring is even with the bottom of the straight edge. For multiple belts, the adjacent belt may be used in place of a straight edge. Remove the tension meter and note the position of the small O-ring, indicating the deflection force applied. Compare this to the recommended range in the instruction manual, or the belt deflection distance shown in Dodge Passport. If the measured force is outside of the range, adjust center distance accordingly until the measured force falls within the allowable range. If tensioning used belts, keep the deflection force towards the lower end of the range. For new belts, keep the deflection force towards the higher end of the range. If multiple belts are being used, repeat and check for each belt. Check belt tension after the first 48 hours of operation and retension if needed. We have put product support at your fingertips. For our online selection program, visit ptwizard.com. For our e-commerce platform, authorized customers can visit dodge.ptplace.com.